The perimeter of a parallelogram is 150 centimeters. One of its side is greater than other side by 25 centimeters. Then I have drawn a rough figure of parallelogram where you can mark the sides. It is given that one of its sides is greater than the other by 25 centimeters. That means if I consider that this side is x centimeters, then the other side will be x plus 25. Okay? The reason for taking this side is because the opposite sides in a parallelogram are equal. If this one is x centimeters, the opposite side will also be equals to x centimeters. So if this is x plus 25, that means the opposite side is equals to x plus 25. Now, perimeter of this parallelogram is given. This is 150 centimeters. There can be two methods for the perimeter of parallelogram, which is sum of all sides, or you can apply the formula 2 into length plus breadth. Okay, I am going to apply 2 into length plus breadth. We are given that perimeter is equals to 150 centimeter. That means 2 into L plus B. The reason for applying this formula 2 into L plus B because the opposite sides are equal. When we have rectangle, then also we apply the same formula. The formula to find out perimeter of rectangle and perimeter is same. 2 into L plus B is equal to 150. Now put the values here. 2 into length, any side you can consider as length. If I consider x plus 25 as length, then x will be breadth. This is equal to 150. Now x and x, 2x. And one more thing, I am taking this 2 which is in multiplication with the bracket. I am taking this 2 to other side. Where it is in multiplication, on the other side it will go in division. After solving, bracket will become 2x plus 25 and this will be 150 upon 2. Okay? Now 2x plus 25 equals to 150 divided by 2. This is equals to 2 sevens are 14, 2 fives are 10, 75. Take this 25 to other side. 2x is equals to 75 minus 25. What is this equals to? 75 minus 25. This is equals to 50. 2x is equals to 50, then x is equals to 50 divided by 2, that means 25. Value of one side is 25 centimeters, and now the other side, which is 25 plus x. So one side is equals to 25 centimeter, other side is equals to 25 plus 25, 50 centimeters. Okay, question was find the measurement of all the sides of the parallelogram. So I have written two measurement here and the other two will be same. If this is x centimeter, if this is 25 centimeter, this is also 25 centimeter, and this is 50 centimeters, so that's that value is also equals to 50 centimeters. Now question number 15 is, there is a rhombus P, Q, R, S, and in this rhombus one angle is marked as 34 degrees and there are two unknown angles X and Y, and the question is find out the values of angle X and angle Y. Okay, so let's find out. You must know all the properties of the rhombus before solving this question. So firstly, I'm going to use the property that diagonals of the rhombus bisect each other at 90 degrees. That means these four angles which are made in the center of the rhombus, these four angles are of 90 degrees each. That means, firstly I am going to take this value. This is 90 degrees. Now, consider this as a triangle L, P, Q, or P, Q, L, any name you can give. Triangle P, Q, L. Okay, in this triangle, this angle is 90 degrees, this angle is 34, and the third angle is missing. Okay? So when we have a missing angle in triangle, we apply angle sum property. So by angle sum property in triangle PQL. The statement will be 34 plus x plus 90 equals to 180 degrees. Okay. Now add 34 and 90. 34 and 90, 124. This is equals to 180 degrees. Now take this 124 to other side. X is equals to 180 minus 124. So x is equals to, subtract them and you will get 56 degrees. So value of x is 56 and now we have to find the value of y. Okay. So I am going to tell you very easy method to find out the second value. That is, see, the property of the rhombus is that all the sides are equal to each other. All the four sides of the rhombus have equal values. Okay. I am going to use these two sides. See, SQ, QP and PS. These three sides make a triangle. PQ and SP are the two sides which are equal to each other. Consider this triangle SPQ. Okay, where SP and PQ, these two sides are equal to each other. So you know that there is a property that if two sides are equal, then the angles opposite to equal sides are equal to each other. Okay, so X is opposite to SP, this side SP. The angle lying just opposite to this side is X and the angle lying just opposite to side PQ is Y. Okay, so the value of X and Y are same. Okay, they both hold same values. And one more thing, if two sides of a triangle are equal to each other, that triangle is called an isosceles triangle. And in an isosceles triangle, the angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So these are the two equal sides and these are the two opposite angles. So if X is equals to 56 degrees, Y is also equals to 56 degrees. And always mention the reason. Y is 56 degrees because angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay. It can be found by using other methods also, but this is the easiest method that I've told you.